There's a microphone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Pearl reporting on Judy. So for today's video, I'm gonna use my microphone because it's kinda maingay dito. For today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you how I do my thumbnails like this. Or about this one. Ito pa. Or ito. Okay. So guys, I hope that you were able to watch my video on the 10 mistakes that we do as, you know, beginners in YouTube, and one of which is a weak thumbnail. So we need to improve our thumbnail. And for today's video, I'm gonna be sharing you how I do that. Stay tuned. Hi guys! Again, thank you so much for being here. It's Pearl. And before we start with the tutorial and how I do my thumbnail, I just wanted to thank everyone who have actually given a very good feedback on my videos. So, lahat po ng mga friends ko, lahat po ng mga subscribers ko. Thank you so much po. So, for today, again, we will be helping each other in making our channel grow. And for today's video, I'm gonna be sharing how I do my thumbnail. So, we will be using just our phone. So, no need for a laptop or anything. You can just use your phone so you can create a good thumbnail. And since we'll be using our phone, then that means that we will be needing one application. So mainly the application that we'll be using here is just the PixArt. But I'll be using another application to cut the picture. It actually depends on you if, you know, you'll be using the same or may iba kayong application na pwede mag-cut na picture nyo. But in my case right now, I will be needing the Adobe Photoshop Mix and the PixArt. So let's have it downloaded po. Okay, I think you have it now. So I'm gonna show my screen now. There you got it. Okay guys, so again, in every tutorial I will be needing your full attention so I can guide you on how to properly do it. So first thing, let's open the Adobe Photoshop Mix. Okay. So right after that, you will see the plus button. Just click on that to open the device. And then pick the picture that you want to use on your thumbnail. So I have already, you know, picked mine. And I like this one. Okay. So I'll be choosing this. After that, you click the cut out. So we can actually, you know, just cut the picture and retain what we wanted to retain in the picture. So click the smart selection. And brush again the area that you wanted to retain. So as you can see in your screen right now, I'm brushing the area that's around my face because that's what I wanted to retain. So don't worry if it's not that perfect, we can do something about that. Let's just keep going, okay? Right. So after that one, guys, palitan natin ng smart selection to basic selection to add and subtract. Okay, now brush ulit natin the parts that we wanted to remove. So like this, as you see on the screen, let's brush that. So again guys, if you have any other application that you can use in cutting the picture, you can also do that. You can just skip this process and then just proceed to the next one. But let me just finish this. Ito kasi yung gamit ko eh. Okay, so almost done. Just bear with me please. Just trying to make it good. Okay, well I think it's okay now. So after you cut out the picture, of course, you wanted to save it. So save muna siya. So it's saving, and we're done saving. So now let's go back to the main screen, and then let's open the PixArt. Again guys, for the PixArt, that's the main application that we will be using in creating our thumbnail. Okay, so it would be the same, just click the plus button to get started. So click natin ang PicCanvas, so make sure guys to set the custom with 1280x720 because that's actually the standard size na required ni YouTube sa atin. So we need to set that one on that, you know, size. So pili tayo ng background image. So but then if you have already a chosen background image, you can use that. You can just skip this part. But again, in my case, I'm gonna be choosing one. So after that, we need to click this arrow, as you can see on your screen, to save the background image. So save to gallery, and it's done. So this would be the start of the proper tutorial. Since we're already, you know, we've already cut out the picture, we've picked our background. So this would be the time in making our thumbnail beautiful and making our thumbnail more creative. Okay, so click natin yung green background photo na ginawa natin earlier. And then we need to add the image that we've just cut out. Okay. So in that case, guys, it would actually depend on you kung saan nyo gusto ilagay yung picture nyo. But then in my case, as you can actually, you know, observe on my thumbnails, I always make it sure na nakalagay siya sa gilid. So it's somewhat, you know, uniform because I want it to be, you know, neat and clean. And also at the same time, parang uniform. Para po hindi siya, no, hindi siya parang masakit sa mata tingnan. That's how I take it. But again, it all depends on you. So I'm gonna put this one at the side. Just like my other thumbnails. Now, let's go to the video title. So this one is very important, guys. So in my case, how I do the video title, it would be, I type the word, I actually type the text word for word. Why? Because there are really times that we wanted to maybe change the font or we wanted to use different fonts in every word. So that can be achieved if we have it written or if we have it typed word for word. So just like what I'm doing right now. Okay, so that's what you can see right now. And guys, aside from that, as you can see on the screen, if we have it word for word, then it would be easier to rearrange. So pwede natin lagay sa gilid, pwede naman insert lang natin dito. Ganun. And as what I've mentioned earlier, you can select font for every word if you like it. If you like to have it in different fonts, you can do that. So just be creative, guys, on what you think will be better for your thumbnail. Okay, so I think it's too flat and it's too simple. So for that one, guys, we can also add shadow on the text. Para magbuka siyang 3D effect. So may 3D effect yung ano natin, thumbnail natin. Aside from the shadow that you can put on your text, you can also add outline. So you just explore in the application. So I think it's not enough yet, so I wanted to add more effects. Para di masyadong boring ang thumbnail natin. So I just used the basic brush na may design. Okay, pili tayo. So we have here the different brushes. Let's try this heart. So you can actually increase the size of the heart. And brush it slightly sa part na gusto nyo, kung saan nyo siya gustong ilagay. You just have to brush it slightly. And also, I think in this picture, it would be better if we add a lens flare. So guys, for this application, there is also an available lens flare. But for that, it would be needing internet connection. So just make sure that you have internet on your phone so you can access the different lens flare that you can, you know, add in your pictures. So try natin this lens flare. Okay, and let's position this one. So again, you're gonna decide where to put it. It's all up to you. So dito na lang, guys. Oh. Okay. Well, I think that would be, you know, that's my taste of creating my thumbnail. So again, if you can check on my other thumbnails, this is how I do it. It should be uniform, it should be simple, at the same time neat, and at the same time classy. So now it's done and you can save it on your, of course, in your gallery. Alright guys, so that's actually the complete steps on how I do my thumbnail. I hope I was able to again help you in deciding how to design your thumbnail. And that is the easiest way in doing it using your mobile phone. Because other creators use, you know, Photoshop and that's kind of hard. So this is the easiest way. All you need to do is to have it downloaded, be more creative, and then just play with colors. That would be all. So I hope I was able to help you in that aspect of your channel. So if you have any other questions about, you know, this video, or if you have another recommendation, so please just comment down below. And also please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you will be notified or you will be updated if I have another videos that might help you. That will be all for today. Thank you so much for your time, guys. See you again in my next video. Bye for now.